Hello, welcome to ISTQB Foundation Level Syllabus, and today we are going to see our next topic, that is activities that are associated with test execution. So let's see what all activities are there with the test execution. So the first activity is executing tests either manually or by using the execution tool. So I have shown you one of the execution tool in my last lecture, so that particular kind of tool only we are using it. So test execution main activity is to execute the test cases, and that you can do it by manually or by using a automation tool. So that is up to you. Now the second point is comparing actual result with expected result. So whatever result we will get, if we are doing it manually, then manually we have to evaluate whether your test case is passed or failed. You will say pass if it is meeting the requirement, and if you will say fail if it is not meeting the requirement. Whereas in automation, you will directly write it in the tool itself, that is called as a comparator, tool comparator. There you will automatically store the result, what should be the passed result, and then tool will tell you whether result is passed or failed. So that is the difference between manual and automation when you are comparing the test result. Now moving to the third point, that is analyzing anomalies to establish their likely cause. This is very important activity in the test execution. So you have executed your test case, but you got some result. Now you have to analyze that result, whether the result is failed because there was a problem in the test environment, or result is failed because there is a actual failure in the software. If there is a problem with the test environment, then we have to correct the test environment and run the test case again. But if we analyze and find that there is a problem with the software itself, then we have to inform to the further people. So that's the reason this particular step is very important in test execution stage, and it is part of the test execution activity. So now moving to the next point, that is logging the outcome of the test execution. So we have to log the outcome of test execution. So we have seen when we were doing in the automation tool in our last class, that we have seen what all times are there, how many test cases are passed, how many test cases are failed, how many test cases are broken, those columns were there in that. So we have to log the outcome of the test execution, that is what we are talking here. Then repeating the test activities either as a result of action taken for an anomaly or as part of the planned testing. So as I told you, after finding out in anomaly that okay, the problem happened because there was a problem in our test environment, then depending upon that, again we can run the test cases. So that is what we are talking here. And when you are in the test execution stage, still you have to verify the bi-directional traceability between test basis, test condition, test cases, test procedure and test result. So this traceability you have to monitor every time, and whichever test process you are in. So hope these 6 points are clear to you. Let's quickly go through it. First thing is where you can perform manual execution of the test case, or automatically you can do it. You have to compare the results, and then you have to analyze the anomalies. You have to log the outcomes of the execution. You have to repeat the activity depending upon the anomaly, whether it is because of your test environment. And then last one is you have to also check the bidirectional traceability. So that is it from this particular topic, test execution. I will see you in my next video. Until then, happy testing.